So yeah, the models that we used, we really, I was having a very hard time, and I've thought about this exact question about moon phases a lot in my previous work. It's very hard to explain to visually impaired children how light behaves when you shine it on objects. And it's a very high-level conceptual thing. So these models are great because they really show the line of where the light leaves. And for those students who've seen the moon before and understand the basic shape that it can take, a crescent moon or a half moon, they don't understand, I don't think, that the moon remains a sphere in the sky. And these models really help to reinforce that, that we only see part of it, but the whole shape is always present.
Have you ever seen the moon before?
No.
So what did you think the moon looked like before?
A mountain?
Have you seen the moon before?
Yeah. Oh, no.
What do you think the moon looks like?
A rock.
So when it's a crescent moon, all you can see is that part that's raised.
Wow.
What do you think your favorite part is about the moon?
How it turns into a crescent moon.
Do you know which one is a crescent in your hand?
Right here.
Is it the same all the time or does it change?
It changes.
Yeah. Okay.
But here's a whole moon crescent and here's a half a moon.
Do you think that 3D printing can be used in the classroom?
I can't tell you how excited I am about 3D printing as a teacher of the visually impaired, because I have all kinds of situations where there's a concept that if I could only, you know, if I could only create this shape, I could explain what's going on in a part of a lesson. I think right now a TVI's, a teacher of the visually impaired's sort of toolbox includes a Braille embosser and a bunch of toys and tools that come from the American Printing House for the Blind. And I think that the next wave will be us creating our own toys and tools and not having to go out and buy those things, and have them be custom built for lessons that we encounter. I think it's a really pivotal place for technology, and especially as 3D printers become more and more advanced and cheaper and faster, and the detail, the resolution is finer, I think we're going to just get an amazing amount of possibilities with creating adapted materials for kids.
Do you think it helped you in learning about what the moon looks like?
Uh-huh.